I have a confession. I never unit test. And I believe you probably shouldn't be writing unit tests most of the time either. Controversial, but put down your pitchforks and hear me out. Here's code that contains a function which fetches account names. You have a database object to help you access your tables, and a prepared statement created from some SQL. As a diligent engineer, you create a unit test to check if your code works well. Then you realize you need to do some mocks. No worries, you set those up. And then comes the pain of defining the return values. Seems suspicious that we fix the behavior to always return the same thing. You run the test and it passes, thinking you've achieved 100% code coverage just like that. Yes, you did a good job in meeting those KPIs, but in practice, this test is useless. What you tested is just all the mockery. This function is supposed to call the database, but in our test, we did none of that. In reality, we are literally just returning a list. Heck, what is the purpose of this? Furthermore, you probably wasted a ton of time setting up those mocks and defining the expected response. A general rule is that if your tests are a magnitude harder to write than the actual code, it's probably bad. Instead of a unit test, an integration test would probably be better. In our setup, we make sure the database is clean and insert some dummy values into it. Then, we could call this function to see if it actually retrieves what we expect. Testing is all about gaining confidence in your code, and this helps us prove that it is actually working as intended, much better than those mock examples. Now, I'm not saying unit tests are all bad. It does have its place when done right. Look at this other function. In this case, it takes in some user object and performs checks on its attributes. It involves a bit of arithmetic and logic, which can be tested reasonably through a few defined cases. Here, this piece of code actually benefited from unit tests simply because we are indeed verifying the internal bits. If you have functions that implement an algorithm, for example, to find the length of the longest substring without repeating characters, unit tests would prove to be very useful. The function itself behaves like a unit, a small part of a larger system. It is obedient and does what it is supposed to do. If the string has length 0, it has no substring, so we return 0. If our string is a bunch of W's, the longest substring is only 1 in length, and so on. Our tests gives us confidence that it works, and we are good to go. Now, you've probably seen this pyramid at some point as a software engineer. Sorry, wrong pyramid. Ah, much better. This test pyramid tells us that to have a maintainable test suite, it should consist of mostly unit tests, followed by a couple of integration tests, and finally, a few end-to-end tests to top it all off. Theoretically, unit tests run faster, which makes it appealing. It is also more isolated and hence easier to test. With that in mind, this pyramid makes perfect sense. But the purest intentions sometimes don't translate well in real life, and we end up writing crappy tests that don't do anything anyway. So, what is the solution? Well, inverting the pyramid is not an option, because now we will be suffering from the overhead of managing numerous end-to-end tests. Instead, let's not touch that section and focus on increasing integration tests while reducing the number of unit tests. In this case, we aim to write more integration tests as long as the speed and complexity of them are reasonable. Have a cron job that reads a database to report a metric? Well, we can test exactly that with some simple data. I dare say it's easier than mocking, and you can actually see things in action. The truth is that the relationship between how integrated the test is and the effort required is not linear. So yes, I never unit test just for the sake of it, but I still write them when it's useful. Ultimately, it's all about finding the right balance of tests that works for you and doing them meaningfully. Remember, the closer we can get to simulating the actual behavior, the more confident we are of our code. And that's the whole point of testing. What do you think?
But graphical, how about testing in production?